Welcome back. We're here to play Remothered.
He says, as this is the first time playing Remothered.
Yeah, well, welcome back to our channel, because I expect zero new viewers. You've all been here before, obviously. There's been a weird resurgence where there's a bunch of third-person horror games cropping up out of nowhere that seem to be from, like, indie projects, and I got some codes, so I figured we can go at these. This would be interesting. Either way for us, really. It's like, either the game ends up being bad, in which case we probably have a crazy camp house thing to have a lot of fun with, or it turns out to be genuinely scary, in which case we get to scare Andrew, and I just can't wait.
No.
I'm gonna make Andrew play this because he told a story a long time ago, about Clock Tower and how he reacted to it as a child.
Yeah, I did.
And is on an old podcast that nobody was around for at that point, I believe. And his first reaction to this was basically like, oh, this looks kind of like Clock Tower. I'm like, well, you're playing then. Fucking trapped.
That's how friendship works,
guys. Do you want to tell the short version of your story?
Basically, the short version was, as a very young boy, I rented a Clock Tower not having any idea what it was. I was terrified and bad at the game because both of those mixed together aren't good.
Yeah.
But I accidentally turned the TV off, and it kept doing the sound of the Clock Tower scissors. And I didn't know that was happening. Like, the screen was black, but I had a sound system, so it was still playing the sound of the shearing scissors, and it scared the shit out of me as a kid because I didn't know where it was coming from. I thought, like, the game was real or something. No, it wasn't good. So I didn't play Clock Tower after that.
But more specifically, didn't you run out of your house and down the street?
I did. I did. It got to a point where I couldn't figure out where it was coming from, but then it kept getting louder.
You were hearing the sound of him approaching you to kill you in the game while the screen was off, so you ran out of your house.
I just ran out of the house, which I felt was fine at the moment. It's a reasonable reaction when you think about someone with giant shears coming at you as a child, but, like, it didn't happen, obviously. Like, there was no guy in the house. I was just a dumb kid.
This will be interesting. It's our first horror game since Resident Evil 7, and our first third-person
horror... Does Resident Evil 7 count as a horror game?
It's our first third-person horror game since Alone in the Dark 2008. So, this will probably be a step up from that one.
Saved game?
Oh, I thought those were difficulties. I'm like, why are they all the same?
They're all birds!
Are you gonna WASD or are you gonna controller?
I'm just gonna WASD, I guess.
I believe in you. You can do it. Just remember all those.
That's a lot of buttons, actually. Do I need to do...
Press F to dodge.
Wait, what? F to dodge? What the fuck am I dodging?
But don't use Q for anything.
Okay.
But they went all the way down to C and V and I and P?
Yeah, wait, what's P?
I is inventory. P is pause, which is also escape.
Fuck you.
Who's not gonna hit escape?
Tab? What is tab?
Tab's your diary. That's pretty normal.
Okay.
Shift is probably run, right?
What's C? Crouch.
Shift is run. Control
is
crouch.
Control.
These are pretty normal. Spacebar is flashlight for some reason because F is dodge.
What's middle click button?
Middle click is
nothing.
The middle click.
Cool. Throw diversion is left.
No, middle click is change diversion.
No, that's V.
No, change diversion is middle click. V is change view.
Where's change diversion?
Middle click. It's under E.
Oh, shit. I didn't even notice it.
E is place diversion. And middle click is change diversion.
Okay.
It's probably a mouse wheel to change which diversion you have selected.
Yeah,
whatever a diversion is.
Okay.
Then you can throw it with left and right click, which I don't know what that means either, but...
So, is it all true?
What have you heard already?
That illness. It thickened the bones. It accelerated the healing process and tissue regeneration. Is that all true?
Every word.
But if that's what it was doing, why call it an illness?
The Lepidopterans made a nest out of the human body where they could eat and multiply. An illness is what it is.
But then?
Where do you want me to start?
From the beginning.
I'm old, Mr. Manny. My memory is not one of my strong points.
Well, for example, why do they call you Madame Svenska?
A name is just a trace. It is our business card, our identifier. It presents us to the world. But does it tell our story or really describe who we are?
swear I know 3 or 4 idiots with the same exact name.
Well, yes. But we are not made of that name. It is given to us. Other people choose it for us, whether it suits us or not. It doesn't tell us who we really are. That name will not give us any answers. It is only through growing old that we become the answer to the questions of our childhood. And living in Sweden the last 30 years has definitely inspired this affectionate moniker. And so, Madame Svenska, it is.
And yet you come back to Italy. Why?
Because I forgot. But I also forgot that I had promised to remember.
Tell me.
Please excuse me. Sometimes my memory needs to be jogged. There's always been a song that, as well as the name you refer to so much, has labeled my whole life, has given it a name, and it's from a name. If you can believe how bizarre and sometimes unbelievable my confused memories are to describe, that all this began.
They got a real sense of cinematography.
Look, yeah, but God, she can't stop shaking for shit.
Yeah, that was interesting animation.
Good. Wait, she has like just an indie song on vinyl?
Yeah, of course. God, this is future vinyl. When vinyl comes back.
I really am getting tired of the indie music starting your game thing. Like,
I don't know if it's indie or not. I don't know what this is. I don't know the song necessarily. I find it interesting that they set up a creepy premise and immediately refuse to talk about it, and they're talking about a name for like 5 minutes.
Yeah, they certainly.
It's like it strengthens your bones, and it also infests you as a breeding ground. We're not going to talk about that anymore. We're going to go on to something else now. Like, what? You're not going to? They were happy to move on from that subject. And I'm like, no, keep what? What's explain? But they knew what they were doing when they made that.
They knew what they were doing. All right, so it's a nice playground. Oh, wait. Oh.
So we know we survive.
Maybe.
Just by how much older we were.
Scully? Wait, are you going to blow out that smoke or what?
No.
Okay, there we go. Like, she just kept inhaling. Oh, I was like, can you just hotbox your car now? I mean, the animation isn't terrible.
Yeah, these are all right. These are all right cutscenes.
Yeah. I mean, it's still like...
It was throwing me for a loop a little bit. They were talking about Sweden and Italy, but everyone's speaking in super American accents.
Right? I love how your cigarette isn't going down at all. It's my favorite part of your cigarette.
It's actually an e-cigarette that's just really, really cool looking.
I mean, I could buy it, I guess. Okay, well, I mean, I'm sorry. I got comfortable. My bad.
Thanks for that.
Like,
yeah, that was the cigarette, too. Ah.
Darril? God damn it, Darril.
It was it's a holographic cigarette. It actually projects the smoke.
But that's my favorite.
It's the E equals MC squared cigarette.
Oh, is that me?
Yeah, you're playing. Reach the residence of Dr. Felton.
Go, girl, go!
She's in a hurry for some reason. Oh, that's a spooky road with the infinite repeating trees.
Okay, we'll take a breath. Hey. I always feel anxious when looking at some icons. Icons and mirrors. Oh, okay. Oh. Ah. Wait, this was the right way?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
You found it.
That was easier than I thought.
Who is it?
Yes, hello. I'm Dr. Reed from the Santa Margarita Institute.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Felton is no longer a patient.
I know. This is why I'm here. Hello? Anyone?
Her voice certainly changed. Okay.
I'm wondering how much the framing device is going to come up, because I'm like, I wonder why they felt the need to explain you're going to live for another 30 years.
What do you mean?
I feel like it kind of does bad things to the overall tension, doesn't it? If you're like, yeah, they'll live, and then you just cut to the protagonist in the past, and that's where the game takes place.
Well, I don't know if we're the same people. We don't know my name, remember?
I'm pretty sure you're the old woman. You look the same, don't you?
Yeah, you have the same necklace, is the only similarity. Because we don't know, again, we don't know the name, because this girl's name's different, obviously, from the old lady, because the old lady's like, ah, it's not my name, I just was given to him. Oh, it's not Clock Tower at all. That's fine.
Wow. Straight up, yeah.
Cut here, cut there. Sears.
Are those like, is that the word for shears or something in a different language?
Probably. It's probably like an Italian skiers. Way to say it. An Italian way to say spooky.
Is this game actually inspired by Clock Tower? I thought we were just stabbing in the dark a bit.
I mean, look, you found
a giant scissors poster at the beginning of the game.
I was the one who said it.
They might be showing their hand.
And I had to experience the trauma of the game.
I mean, you do have a bit of a sixth sense for horror inspirations.
Which is sad, because
we were looking at PT, and you and Joe were like, oh, these guys should really make a Silent Hill game. And I was like...
Yeah.
Because you didn't know that it was a Silent Hill game.
It's not a great ability, given the fact that I hate the genre usually.
Oh.
So I don't really particularly like to be...
Can you just try to open the door?
No, I just wanted to check the other routes.
Oh. Well, you found an Easter egg that really shows their hand. All right.
Well, thank goodness. They have a dog, but I hope the dog doesn't bother me.
Creepy.
That?
Weird little tombstone-looking, like, Pac-Man ghost little prints everywhere.
Oh.
They look like 100 faces. Why would you make them look like that?
I don't know. But I'm going to check some stuff out. Let's see what you got in this property.
Instead of walking up to the door, you just casually start touring the premises without permission.
I feel like it's the best option, right? You should always, like, know your surroundings.
I want to fully explore your house and look for loot.
Well, yeah. But also, like, you want to make sure that you have a good exit plan in
place.
Let
somebody in your front gate, they start beelining up and down the garden, like, I'm looking for collectibles.
Yeah-ha-ha! Yeah-ha-ha! You found me!
That was a weird sound, right?
A little bit, but I think that's like cars moving.
Or a lion.
This looks like Resident Evil 7.
What, like everything? Or that? Oh, the very lit up plat. It's a table that's super lit up, like you expected to have a tool on it that you need to continue.
Yeah, it's like a tool workbench or
There's
something.
There's a lot to be said about how video games have conditioned us to think like something that's lit up is super important.
I mean, in life, that's how it is too.
It's generally a really good way of handling level design without just having a giant glowing arrow pointing at something.
I mean, it also reminds me of Resident Evil 7 of, like, the garden.
Abusing this girl. Like, she's so winded.
She just acts like that. She's fine.
You keep running everywhere. She's immediately winded at the beginning of the game when she's just nothing tense has happened.
What? Is that giant lipstick or chapstick?
Are those bloody scissors?
Oh, wait. They are Sears. There's Sears. Yeah, like, I don't know. I'm getting the vibe because the garden thing.
Is that giant chapstick? As opposed to, like, just any spray can of any kind.
We'll see.
They still have a lot of copies of the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a big garden.
It's just, like...
They got a spray paint in all green.
There's something about, like, really shitty managed gardens that make me spooked. I don't know why. Wait, what's her name? I can't read on her boobies. What is her name?
I feel like there's a better approach to make there. I cannot do that now.
Okay, I'm sorry. I won't look anymore.
The gate was open. Are you there? Hello?
Didn't we get on the intercom when they told us to leave?
What?
What did they say on the intercom? Didn't they tell us to go away or he's not in now or something?
No, she was just like, she just said, Mr. Fenton's not a patient anymore. And then I was like, yeah, that's why I'm here. And then she hung up. And I was like, okay.
Seemed like explicit and like non-permission to not come in. And we came in anyway. And they're like, hey, the gate was open. It's like, we've already talked. You can't act like we haven't talked yet.
I guess the thing, though, is that because there was no implicit, like, please go away, she just hung up and then the gate was unlocked, which you could infer that was unlocked because of the lady, because it should be an electronic gate.
No, I'm too socially awkward to press forward like this.
I mean, I'm definitely not somebody who would also walk into some random person's property.
Yeah.
Also, like,
you gotta stand your ground laws in this country.
Why do you have a lawnmower for...
That they leave. But it's like left in the middle of the garden.
There's not even lawn to mow. It's just...
Yeah. I'm a little uncertain. There's flowers everywhere, so it feels like you'd be mowing all the flowers. But also, you just left... They left the lawnmower out.
I mean, they also left the gate unlocked, so yeah. These people aren't really, like...
Maybe it's already taken over by monsters.
I'm just gonna keep running until she stops being able to run.
Ladder?
Okay. I'll keep that in mind
for your later escape.
Yeah, I'll remember that when it's time to escape.
Yeah. I'm sure that long hallway won't come in handy during a chase scene or anything.
She is, like, so easily winded, it kind of concerns me.
Yeah.
Are we going to do a whole horror game with a woman who can't run more than, like, 10 feet?
I think it's supposed to be less winded and more, like, scared sounding.
But it doesn't really work.
But, yeah, she already makes scared noises when running before anything scary has happened. So she kind of sounds terrified, even though we're just, like, meandering in a garden.
Right? It feels... She either feels like she is the most poorly... She has, like, almost no stamina, or she is terrified all the time. Like, so much as moving her heels a little
too
fast.
The plot twist is that it's the old woman in makeup to make her look young. That's why she's so winded.
That would be pretty
hilarious.
She's,
like, 90 years old. I feel like that's rude, right?
It's invasion of private property.
The ears to the window stuff, like, are they coming?
Okay, that's rude.
Now you're smoking on somebody else's property.
Yeah, now that's rude.
She smokes a lot.
Yes? Good evening.
Miss Reed, you already told me at the intercom, and as I already told you, Mr. Felton is no longer a patient at the Institute.
I came here voluntarily, outside the Institute.
So what do you want?
I am personally re-examining your case. Causes, reagents. I strongly believe there are alternative ways and probably other experiments that are worth a try. I am fighting with the Institute to recognize there are other adequate remedies for your husband's pathology.
Oh, no, please. I'm just assisting him. I'm his nurse.
I didn't know.
It's okay.
What?
I suppose you want to talk to him.
Also, I'm still have a lit cigarette.
I apologize for the darkness, but Mr. Felton's sight has been damaged and immensely compromised because of the disease. Anyway,
go ahead and keep smoking.
And please, refrain from smoking inside.
Oh, thank you.
Mr. Felton hates the smell of smoke.
Sorry.
Wait, then who's been smoking in here?
Yeah, I don't know where those other cigarettes came from.
Also, why does everyone
move?
Does
she keep getting guests that keep knocking on the door then smoking immediately? While they wait for the door to get answered.
I like the lore that is just a common occurrence.
Right, does it just hurt you, that their soul, that they're wasting them like that?
It does, yeah. God, it does. Also, where did she put it out at? Oh, right there. Okay,
there it is.
Good lore building. Good world building.
Hey, it was way brighter, wasn't it? Is there not one on that table? It's not.
No.
I can't do it now.
She can't run anymore.
Oh.
Well,
enjoy your spooky house. I'm sure nothing scary will happen in here.
Why does everyone violently shake? You notice that? Like when in the cutscenes, they just always like shake weird. Wait, okay, this is like okay. Hold on, wait a second. Habit.
Smoking.
She's criticizing you.
I don't know. I don't like this lady.
Why? Because she has her back turned to
you?
No,
something. No. I wasn't thinking about it before. This lady's hella fishy.
the spooky nurse for the person that's not a patient anymore.
Like, she is deathly pale. Like, almost inhumanly pale.
Yeah, or she's just a horror game character, which they're all pale.
She's also, like, poorly dressed. Like, it's kind of, I don't know.
That's like what I expect a house nurse might dress like.
You should quit. You have no idea how bad this is for you. Not only for your health, but it's also very expensive. Money and time wasted.
I already quit. Shut up.
What you do every day? I couldn't waste time with such a bad habit.
Getting this full rant when you just quit smoking,
right?
Oh no, from midday to 8 p.m. Then I go back home. I live near here. If needed, he can contact me with a pager, but that's not often. His wife takes care of him when I'm off.
What can you tell me about her?
I met her just a couple of times. She's usually out or locked in her bedroom when I'm here. Let's say they don't seem to get along.
I didn't know.
But, you know, when she's home, she listens to the same music, the same song, over and over.
Is it the song from the intro?
Probably. That hipster indie bullshit.
The evil song of the game. Turns people into remothers. Whatever that means.
Can I just explore your house?
This game has the most vaguely uncomfortable but incomprehensible name of being called Remothered, which is like, what?
I don't really
want to know what that means.
Wait, I guess.
But
just
we will,
going?
I guess. I guess, if you want to be creepy. Oh. They blocked your progress. You've been barricaded.
Ah. Camera.
It's a completely normal barricade.
Yeah, right? This house is a normal functioning household. We just also barricaded a door.
Yeah, that's where the bear is.
God, could you not walk as if you don't have anywhere to be today? Because you have places to be today.
Exploring?
I mean, kinda. You should probably get to know the environment you're going to be chased in for the next, like, 12 hours.
Yeah.
Like,
you could, but this is the slowest way to do it, is in the scripted sequence where you're not allowed to run.
This way, please. Mr. Felton will be here in a few minutes.
What?
Okay.
Wait, what? No, wait, no. Bring me to his room.
Nope, they're gonna lock you in the murder room.
Yeah,
now they're gonna gas you. We're just gonna quietly ignore the fact that I'm pretty sure you're alive 30 years from now. Yeah, there's a dot in your hair.
Ah! Someone wash it out. Why is there so much Jesus?
Why is there so much Jesus?
The collection of a virgin. Coronation, sorry. It's really hard to read that.
It's very small.
The young girl gazes into the sky above with stunned eyes and a light hits her. But something is out of place. From the dark sky, the threatened storm are descending in hideous hands of strange creatures. This picture makes me feel uncomfortable.
No.
I mean, is it the virgin part?
That I mean, it looks like somebody's being abducted.
I mean, it probably is. What are bugs? Notary? Patron, entrepreneur, and even...
Entomologist.
Entomologist with a green thumb. Oh, she's just listing off the things that he is?
Apparently.
He's a Patreon subscriber?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, that's pretty nice.
He's the one that keeps nominating all the Zeldas.
This sickly old man in a haunted mansion is nominating a bunch of Zeldas.
Play Majora's Mask. It's the only thing that brings me joy anymore. When Keith stops playing Zelda, my heart stops beating.
Wait, was this door here?
I mean, you went in a circle.
Yeah.
You went down a hallway, I mean. Like, that's not where you started.
Yeah, why is there... Wait, did she put me in an office, or she put me in someone else's room?
I mean, everything in this place is huge.
It is kind of, like, ridiculous.
Can you play the film reel?
I can't do anything. Maybe he'll show me later. Also, wait, where does that door go?
Goes behind. What a huge room. Quick, search his desk.
Oh.
It's your chance to spy on him.
Well, I mean, I think I have to in order for the game to progress. So I'll do it. Oh, he has a letter opener on his table.
Told you they're real.
Or a knife. I can't tell. Mr. and Mrs. Felton's farm, Rosogallo, closes. Danger of contamination. Wyman and the Feltons
indicted for alleged criminal activity against consumers and production employees.
Okay.
October 2nd, 1971. The Rosogallo farm, Pride of the Gallows, that's an unfortunate name to have, closed due to suspected contamination. It has been reported that many products have been infected by toxic pollen that could be the cause of severe parasitosis. The owner, Ariana Gallo, top right, her husband, the notary, Richard Felton, bottom right, professor, and company's partner, Albert Elias Wyman, large picture, are under investigation. The latter has been allegedly accused by Felton himself of having used the company to carry out pharmaceutical experiments, taking advantage of corporate funds at his will. Indeed, the warning came from the residents at the company's headquarters, the Ashmans, who managed the building and supervised the harvesters. The city, sisters of the adjoining convent. Among the reported symptoms, painful ulcers, vomiting, proliferation of parasites, and in some cases, keratosis, photosensitivity. Following the heavy allegations, both the Feltons and the Ashmans received numerous threats from Wyman himself, who has been removed from the Order of Physicians today. Wyman stated he was shocked by the charges and pointed his finger to his former business partner, Richard Felton. "He personally funded me." It is worth noticing that Felton himself, like his father, promoted and funded the Phenoxyl Project, a drug for which Wyman himself was nominated for the prestigious medicine award in 1957, but that was retired from the market a few years later due to the disastrous side effects. Meanwhile, even at Felton's house, which was used as location of product distribution, the activities ceases. As a result of the scandal, the Ashmans and Feltons also broke off any kind of relationship. As a matter of fact, the Ashmans claimed a substantial refund for the damage they suffered because even their children have been infected, and as a consequence, used as unaware test subjects. The authorities assume that the contamination has developed from the groundwater, not only used for the irrigation of nearby plantations, but also as a common source for the Ashmans and the 12 sisters of the nearby monastery. A lot going on there. Go for it.
You damn son of a bitch! See what they write about me on the news? You wanted to tarnish me, but I'll get back at you! Oh, surely I will. Starting with your daughter, do you believe she doesn't know who her father is? I'm sure she'd be glad to know that she is his daughter. Show you've got balls. Take your own responsibilities. What am I saying? Balls? You never got balls?
Shit. Shots fired at the guy that we're here to meet.
Thanks for the prologue, though.
I assume he was the recipient.